Hi, folks. So this is question four. So it starts off, so it's all trigonometry. It starts off with a proof. So the proof of this is in your textbook. You need to have learned this, really. So you have to prove that tan of A minus B is equal to the tan A minus tan B over 1 plus tan A tan B. So you have to prove that. So we're going to start off with tan of A minus B. Now, tan is always equal to sin over cos, so that's going to be the first step of it. So that's the same thing as sin A minus B over cos of A minus B. And then we can expand out sin of A minus B, so you have to go to your log tables again. So sin of A minus B, if you look for what that is in your log tables, it's sin of A cos of B minus sin B cos A. And if you look for what cos of A minus B is in your log tables, it's cos A cos B plus sine A sine B. So it's getting a little bit more complicated. And then next step, we're going to divide everything by cos A cos B. Okay, that's just what we have to do. So we're going to divide everything in it by cos A cos B. And the reason we're kind of doing that is because we're getting back to kind of the first step. We know that sin over cos is tan. So we have to get back to tans really here to get everything back into a tan. So you're going to divide everything by cos A cos B. So sin A cos B over cos A cos B minus, so we're sitting on the top line, sin B cos A over cos A cos B. So I'm writing the same thing again, but I'm putting everything over each thing individually over cos A cos B. And then we've got cos A cos B over cos A cos B, so that's going to be 1 plus sine A sine B over cos A cos B. Right, so it's looking complicated here then, but it'll simplify down out here from here. So if you look at kind of what the things that cancel, so that cos, sorry, wrong thing. Yeah, that cos B and that cos B, they'll cancel out because there's one above and below the line. That cos A and that cos A will cancel out, so those two are gone. Here then everything all cancels out. Cos A cos B is above the line and cos A cos B is below the line. So they'll all cancel out into just one. And then here yeah, so nothing cancels out there yet. So let's rewrite it then. So we've got sin A over cos A minus sin B over cos B all over just one because they all cancel out plus sin A over cos A and sin B over cos B. So then we're almost done. Sin A over cos A here, this sin A over cos A, that will just be tan A. Because we know that sin over cos is always just tan. This sin B over cos B will just be tan B then. So it's minus tan B. And then this one is just one. And then we're getting the sin A over cos A here is tan A. And the sin B over cos B here is tan B. So tan A tan B. So plus tan A tan B. And then that's it. That's what we were asked to prove. So next part then, right tan of 15 degrees. Now there's a clue kind of from the first part. You're going to use that rule really. So tan of A minus B. So because you've got tan of 15, there's nothing really for tan of 15 in your log tables, or you already know what tan of 15 is. So we're going to call tan 15. We're going to call it tan of 60. Take away 45, because 15 is just 60 take away 45. But then we can use that rule, and if we have things with tan of 60s and 45s, we have values for them that make it easier. So we're going to use that rule from above then. So tan, so it's this rule, it's the same as what we had. So tan A minus tan B over 1 plus tan A tan B. So A is 60 and B is 45. So tan of 60 minus tan of 45 over 1 plus tan 60 tan 45 equals, and then root tan of 60 is just going to be root 3. You can use calculator or you can use your log tables. Minus, and tan of 45 then is just 1. And 1 then is just going to be 1. And then root 60 again is just going to be root 3. And you have to times that by the tan of 45, which is 1. So that's, we almost have it in the form that we want. So root 3 plus minus 1 over 1 plus root 3. And then just to change it into exactly into that form up here from in the question, you can just change it to root 3 minus 1 over root 3 plus 1. And then that's it. That's what you were asked for. So key there was to see that if you got tan of 15, changing into tan of 60 minus 45, and then you can use the log tables. Okay, so part B of the question then. Okay, so it says in the question, important thing to see here is that AC is equal to BC. So if AC is equal to BC, that has to be an isosceles triangle. So if it's isosceles, then that angle down here and that angle there, they have to be the same. That's the first part. There's a few different ways of doing this as well. So you can work out what those angles are. You can do 180, take away 45, which is 135. And then do 135 divided by 2. And you'll get 67.5. So each of these are 67.5. Now there's a couple of ways of going from here. One way you could do it is you could split it down the middle there like that, and you get a right angle triangle, and you can actually use Sokotoa, you can use junior sort of stuff to work out the side there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use sine rule. Doesn't really matter what way you do it. So we want this AC side. We want the length of AC. So this is AC out here, this side. So sine rule says that if you take a side, so we'll take AC, if you put that over the sine of the angle opposite, so sine of, in this case, the angle opposite is 67.5. That has to be equal to the any other side. So we'll take the 10 2 minus root 2. 10 root 2 minus root 2. So it's a little bit complicated, that number there. You put that over sine of the angle opposite that. So sine of 45. And then you've got one unknown. You could call that ACX instead or something if you want, but you don't really need to. So all you have to do to get AC by itself is to move over the sin 67.5 and multiply it. So that's equal to 10 root 2 minus root 2 over sin 45 times by sin of 67.5. And then you put all that into the calculator. You need to be careful with the little root inside it, another root in that. But you should get 10 units when you round it off. So, yeah, so 10 units. Okay, we don't have, doesn't tell us whether they're centimeters or whatever in the question. So, just 10 or 10 units. And then that's it. That's all for that question.